Hello, father and daughter. How wonderful to have you with us. I can't think of too many situations musically where fathers and daughters have come to work together with the kind of intimacy with which you two have. Can you each share with us from your own perspective a little bit of what that has been like for you?
It's just a great emotional experience. You kind of want your kids to do what you do, if that's possible. She puts the work in and she's amazing, and I get to stand and act like it's all because of me.
Anytime we get to do like a session together or shows, it's always, I always look back, you know, with pride and very glad that we have an opportunity to do it.
Tell me a little bit about how your heart beats for Curtis Mayfield.
Curtis Mayfield is the poet laureate of Black American music. He would have internal rhymes that would catch you off guard. And in addition to having rhymes at the ends of sentences. And so there was just, oh man, just so much to learn.
And just that voice, just the voice alone. The way he tells a story is probably one of the most covered songs to date. And just going back and really listening just to how he tells that story, it gives me chills just thinking about it. I think that's why it's reached so many people and it's really become kind of a marker of the civil rights movement.
Get ready, there's a train coming. Don't need no baggage, you just get on board. All you need is faith to hear the diesel humming. You don't need no ticket, you just thank the Lord. Thank you, Lord.
People get ready for the train to Jordan, picking up passengers coast to coast. Faith is the key. Open the doors and boredom. There's hope for all among those loved the most.
To save his own, have pity on those whose chances grow thinner, for there's no hiding place against the kingdom's throne.
So people get ready,
there's a train coming,
you don't need no baggage,
you just get on board.
All you need is faith
to hear the diesel humming.
You don't need no ticket.
You just thank.